This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to find the average rate of a trip that has more than one part. So we're going to be using the formula rate times time equals distance. But from this formula, remember if you wanted to find the rate or the time, you could divide the left-hand side either by r or t. So if you divided the both sides by t, you would have the rate is distance over the time. And if you were looking for the time, you could say that's the distance over the rate. All right, so that comes from the same formulas here. So here's our problem. If John travels 30 miles to work at an average rate of 40 miles per hour, but travels the 30 miles home at a rate of 60 miles per hour, what is the average rate for the entire time driving to and from work? All right, well, first of all, a lot of people think that you can just take these miles per hour and take the average. In other words, they say, well, it's 30 miles there, 30 miles home. So if you go 40 miles per hour there and 60 miles per hour home, isn't the average rate 50 miles per hour? And as it turns out, it's close to 50 miles per hour, but it's not exactly that. If you're taking a multiple choice test, you'll see that is one of the possibilities. They'll just put 50 miles per hour, but that will be wrong. So let's figure out how you would do this problem correctly. So what we want to do is figure out the total time of the trip. Because if we know the total distance and the total time, we'll be able to figure out the rate. Now, the total distance, well, it's 30 miles there and 30 miles back. So hopefully that makes sense to you. You're going to have 60 miles total distance. But let's figure out the time it takes to drive to work. So we're trying to figure out the time. So we're going to use that formula. It's just distance over rate. So the time is just going to be, in this case, distance over rate, 30 over 40. Now, it's going to be in hours because notice the rate's in miles per hour. All right, so if the rate's in miles per hour, we want the distance to be in miles and the time to be in hours. So this is 3/4 of an hour, or you could write it like that, 3/4 of an hour if you reduce it. All right, what about going home? Same formula, right? Distance over rate. So the time it takes to get home is 30/60 of an hour, or half an hour. Now the first thing you should do is see if these numbers I'm coming up with make common sense to you. So it's 30 miles to work. You're only going 40 miles per hour. So you're going less than 40 miles, so it's going to take less than an hour to get to work. All right, how about going home? You're going 60 miles an hour, and if you're only going 30 miles, that's only half an hour. That makes sense because you should be able to go a whole 60 miles in 1 hour, and you're only going half that distance. So hopefully this also makes sense. So here we go. We've got the total distance is 60 miles. What about the total time? Well, we have to add the two times, the time going to work plus the time going back home. So that's what we do. We're going to add those up. 3/4 plus 1/2. Right now you have to remember how to add fractions. One way is you just get a common denominator here by noting the common denominator is 4. So then we have the numerators added together. 3 plus 2 is 5/4. So our total time is 5/4. Which happens to be an hour and 15 minutes, but basically it's 5/4 of an hour. So if you know the distance and you know the time, how do you get the rate? That's what we're looking for, right? That's the question. So what's the average rate? Well, we know that the rate is the distance over the time, and I'm going to write that as d divided by t. That's the same thing. When you write d over t, that's the same thing as saying d divided by t. And since I'm working with fractions, I think it's easier to write it as d divided by t. So let's do that. So the average rate will be what? Well, look up here. Here is the distance, and here is the time. So we've got 60 divided by 5/4. Right, how do you divide with fractions? So that's the same thing as 60 over 1 times the reciprocal, 4/5. All right, so we can cancel here. And that gives me 48. And then we're talking about a rate. We really want the answer of 48 miles per hour. Okay, so the entire trip, it's saying the average rate is 48 miles per hour. Now remember, here's the original problem here. That I said a lot of people will say it's 50 miles per hour. Notice it's not 50 miles per hour, but it's close. It's a little less than that. It's 48 miles per hour. So now let's check it. So here's the problem. We got 48 miles per hour. So does it make sense if the rate is 48 miles per hour and the time, remember, we said was 5/4. We added the 3/4 plus 1/2. And the distance we know was the total of 60. Is it true that rate times time equals distance? So we're just going to check that out. We're going to do rate times time, which is 48 times 5/4. And let's see if we cancel. Gives you 12. And that gives you 12 times 5 is 60. And does that match? Yes, it does. So, yep, it makes sense if we check our answer. So this is just a little check to make sure the rate times the time for the total trip makes sense, right? Because this is for, should have maybe written this, that this was checking our answer here. So this is just checking answer for total trip.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.